Well, about 2.5 years ago, we were awarded 2 grants to work on shark deterrents using our basic knowledge of the sensory abilities of sharks and their relatives to develop novel deterrents and to test existing devices that are currently on the market that the public can be using to deter and change shark behaviour.
And so we're looking to see whether we can look outside the square and discover new things which sharks might be frightened of. First of these, strobe lights, bright flashing lights. It was found that they were quite effective in the lab, but when we took this into the field, white sharks certainly weren't frightened of the bright flashing lights, and so this isn't an effective strategy to deter certainly large predatory sharks during the day. Second thing we tested was loud underwater sounds. Now there is some evidence that very loud sounds are repellent to sharks as well as bony fishes. And white sharks are thought to, if not be frightened, but wary of killer whales. But we saw no effect of the killer whale scream. And in fact, artificial sounds which took the essence of that killer whale scream also weren't seen to be repellent. So the third thing we tested were the bursts of bubbles, let off very quickly when a shark approached, would scare them away. And in fact, we found this to be quite effective at scaring off white sharks. And so although it's early days, we think this could be a strategy for a personal deterrent, and certainly is something people could do in an emergency if they were diving, to let out a burst of bubbles from their scuba gear in the face of an approaching shark, if they had the time to do so. All of this research and all of the valuable insights we've gained wouldn't be possible without the financial support of the Western Australian State Government through the Applied Research Program for their Shark Hazard Mitigation Project, and also the University of Western Australia.
One of the grants was to concentrate on testing and possibly improving on existing devices that were currently on the market. We were able to test the shark shield and found for about 8 species of different reef sharks that it was effective. All of the tests were very positive, not only for tiger sharks and other reef sharks off WA, but also on white sharks off South Africa. It was important for UWA and our research team to step in and provide our expertise in developing and testing these devices to protect the public from somewhat of a menace which has changed people's behaviour in entering the beautiful waters off the WA coastline.